Have we ever stopped to ask that boy that carries a knife what he wants to do when he's older? If his parents are still together and who his role models are? Cause I guarantee you he don't live next door to a doctor. Instead, he's more than likely to be riding with thugs. And they're the ones in the community prescribing the drugs and driving those cars. And I wonder if, as a teenager, he's watching how the olders carry themselves and it's learned behavior. I wonder if by the age of 12 he never had a father, and why? At the age of 13 he had his first balaclava. Was he ever scared? Is it the mum don't care, or is it just that she was never there? Maybe she's out trying to provide for the family, and by the time she gets back she feels tired and angry. Are the arguments at home, is there a lack of affection? Are the boys outside offering you protection? From the youths up the road in a different postcode, the reason why you always go the long way home. So the olders on the block become your bigger brothers. Now it's almost as if you're related to each other. Gang related. Now we've got a council estate kid filled with hatred who needs to be initiated before he's fully affiliated. Is that environment just making him numb? Does he have a choice, or is it safety in numbers? Because they're not meant to be your mentors. That's what we need grown men for. To lead by example and to nurture ambition. To teach discipline, to understand and to listen. And I apologize for generalizing, for coming across like I'm stereotyping. But we all need to know we are marginalizing a whole generation when we criminalize them. Who really wants to end up in prison or dying? And the social networks make it all look exciting. The way that gangs incite violence live online, and it's followed by an advert to make sure we're still buying. And I'm not about to blame this all on drill, but thoughts become words, and words become real. So tell me there's not a vested interest in what's manifesting, when all the kids can hear is I splashed him and I chefed him, dipped him outside of his house and then left him. For his mum to find him? Have you been to a funeral and heard a mother crying? When her son's in the ground, it sounds like she's dying. It's been like this for years, wiping those tears and printing those T's, saying put the knife down, blaming police, writing to our local MPs. I've seen mums at knife crime rallies begging on their knees like, they've took my son, but make it stop, please. And it's our responsibility. Have you heard it takes a village to raise a child? But we're losing our community, so they're left to run wild. And this isn't the time for answers or excuses, but the youngers need to know there's consequences for their offences. Justice will be served if you're caught or let go, because when you take a life, you forfeit your own.